Hey there, guys. Today we're going to be taking a dive into the fascinating world of 3D printing and show you how to optimize your Cura slicer and Klipper firmware to get the highest print speed, accuracy, and efficiency. As you may already know, Cura is a very popular slicer, while Klipper is a super powerful firmware that can boost your 3D printer's performance to the next level. However, getting these two fascinating tools to work together smoothly can be a bit tricky. You see, Cura wasn't built to work with Klipper firmware natively, and the G-code flavor used by Klipper is slightly different to Marlin. But it's all good, because I got your back, because in this video, I'm going to show you the best tips and tricks I've found to optimize Cura to work with Klipper seamlessly. Get ready to streamline your 3D printing process. So stick around and let's get into it. Okay, so Cura is a super popular 3D printing slicer, in a large part due to the fact that it has so many features and options for converting 3D printed models into G-code. It's worth noting that Cura was optimized for particular 3D printing software, specifically Marlin. This means that even though Cura works well with Klipper, which utilizes advanced techniques like offloading most of the printer's processes to an external computer and advanced built-in features like pressure advance and input shaping, there are certain options that need to be tweaked in order to optimize compatibility and get the most out of Klipper, because Cura wasn't directly built to support it. And Klipper uses a slightly different G-code flavor than Marlin. So there's a whole ton of options out there to help you streamline the process. And today I'm going to be going over a few of the best that I've found that kind of helped me to get Cura and Klipper to play nice together, you know? First, I'm going to be going over a couple of options in Cura that need to be changed in order to prevent compatibility issues with Klipper. Then we're going to be looking at some easy ways to get back some of the functionality you lose from Cura after switching over to Klipper by using macros. After that, I'm going to show you guys some of the plugins that can help make your life a lot easier when you're using Cura with Klipper. And finally, a simple little tip that I found that really helps me to maximize my 3D printer speed, and it works with almost every 3D printer. So if you want to find out what that is, it might be a good idea to stick around to the end. By the way, guys, I kind of got to apologize for my voice in this video. I'm a little under the weather, but it was important for me to get this out to you guys. So let's start out by diving into some of the conflicting options in Cura with Klipper. So to unlock the full potential of Klipper and achieve optimal printing results, it's crucial to fine-tune your slicer settings. Let's get into the nitty-gritty of slicer settings that could cause compatibility issues and show you how to tweak them so you can streamline your 3D printing experience. Let's start out with the coasting option. So this is a feature that turns off extrusion towards the end of each line to prevent boogers. If you're familiar with pressure advance, this might sound a little bit familiar. Well, this may seem like a good idea. It will directly interfere with your pressure advance settings, which relies on a steady flow of filament to maintain printing consistency. So to prevent this conflict, it's important to disable coasting in Cura's experimental settings tab. The next thing you're gonna wanna look out for is acceleration control and jerk control in Cura's speed settings, because these things can really mess up Klipper's advanced techniques. It's important to point out though that in current Klipper versions, jerk control is already ignored, but it's better to get rid of it anyway, in my opinion. On the flip side, using Cura's retraction settings can actually enhance your prints. Even after pressure advance has been fine-tuned, a small retraction distance like 0.75 millimeters can be particularly beneficial to filaments that like to stick to the nozzle. By taking these steps to optimize Klipper settings, you can really advance the functionality that you get out of Cura when using Klipper. I mean, this is really important, I think. But arguably more important than that, let's talk about some macros. So if you've been using Cura for any amount of time and switched over to Klipper, you might have noticed that your filament change option is not really working as it did before. And that goes for pause print and a whole bunch of other ones too. I mean, I personally use filament change and pause print pretty regularly. So the reason that these options aren't really working as they used to is because Klipper doesn't really recognize the M600 command right out of the box. you kind of need some macros for that. Okay, so for those guys that don't know, in Klipper, a macro is a sequence of predefined G-code commands that your printer kind of executes as a single command, kind of like a sandwich. It's like one piece of food, but it's made up of a whole bunch of, anyway. So you can use macros to set up sequences. For example, homing, which takes several G-code commands together to work properly. So each macro can be customized, and you can customize Klipper using the customized macros. So it's a lot of customization. I mean, you can use it for homing, changing filaments, pausing your print, running calibrations. However, because Klipper uses a slightly different G-code flavor than Marlin, some basic commands like the M600 command to do a filament change or the M0 command for stop print are not directly supported. So picking them in the post-processing option of Cura won't do much. But don't worry, because the Klipper community has your back, and they've already done all the hard work for us by compiling a bunch of useful macros on their GitHub page, linked down in the description. All you have to do is pick the feature that you want to get up and running on your printer, copy the macro that's written down right in the page, and slap it into your printer config file using the web UI of your choice. Now, this might sound a little bit intimidating, but I'm telling you, it's pretty simple once you get it going. And once you're done doing that, you just restart your printer and enjoy the seamless functionality that's returned to you in Cura. But to really get some of that seamless functionality, we're gonna need some plugins to get things really rolling. But before we dive into the meat of this video, let me just say that if you're enjoying this so far, please consider subscribing and maybe even hitting that like button. It helps me out a lot. Please bear with me a minute, because I just wanna say thank you to all the guys that have been really supportive and have left some really amazing comments. These comments are truly appreciated by me. And I see some of these things, and it really gives me motivation to keep going and making more and better videos. And thank you. I just, I feel it's really important to say thank you. Anyway, enough about that. Let's get back into it. Okay, so let's talk about some plugins that can really help take your Cura and Klipper printing game to the next level. First up is the Moonraker Connection plugin by MTrax. You can easily find this plugin right on Cura's marketplace. This plugin is a game changer, as it lets you upload sliced objects directly to your printer from Cura. That means no more fiddling around with SD cards or clunky file transfers. Just hit print and let Moonraker Connection take care of the rest. If you're using Creality's API or the Sonic Pad, don't worry, because this plugin works just as seamlessly with these as well. Next up, we have Klipper Settings plugin by JJ Graphics. This plugin is an absolute must-have if you're looking to customize and fine-tune your printer settings. It provides an intuitive interface within Cura that lets you tweak everything from motor settings to temperature sensors to advanced macro commands. Best of all, it eliminates the need for complex command line inputs or manual config file editing, making the whole process a breeze. Unfortunately, I couldn't personally find this plugin on Cura's marketplace, but I've linked the GitHub page in the description, so you can grab it from there along with all the other stuff I've discussed in this video, including the last plugin, and some affiliate links for some awesome 3D printing gear that you might want to check out. So there you have it, two awesome plugins that can help you streamline your Cura Klipper experience. So as we've seen, there's plenty of ways to customize Cura for Klipper, but in my experience, the things that I went through with you guys in this video are the most essential customizations that you can get. The most useful ways to really get Klipper and Cura running smoothly together. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. Really, there's a whole ton of other stuff out there. Speaking of which, that little tip that I promised you, let's get into that. It's a really simple trick. Just increase your print speed by 50 millimeters a second until you hit that sweet spot. That's about it. It may sound too easy, but trust me, it works. Of course, everyone's printer is different. Different extruder, different nozzle, hot end, and so on and so forth. So this may be the most universal method. Anyway, I think it's worth a try. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you might enjoy this one next. See you soon. Bye for now.